Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. A few days ago, Rainbow Six Siege finally got its tick rate increased to 60 Hz. So in today's video, we will once again take a look at the networking of this game to find out if the last two patches actually improved something. If you want to know more about the changes that were done in the previous updates, then you can find the link to my video in the description down below. In the description as well as in the card overlay in the top right corner, you can also find a link to my Netcode 101 video, where I explain a few basics about video game networking, like tick rates, update rates, network models, super bullets, lag compensation, packet loss, as well as a few other things, like how I do my network delay tests. So in case that you have never watched one of my netcode analysis videos before, you should really go and see the Netcode 101 video at least once before you continue with this video here. Okay then, what changed in Rainbow Six Siege since I tested it the last time? Previously, the ping that you've seen in the scoreboard was not only always higher than what you got for the data center that you connected to, it was also affected by your frame rate, where it got higher when your frame rate went down and it got lower when your frame rate went up. This was because the value that the game showed you in the scoreboard also included the processing delays of the game, while the value that you got for the connection to the data center was more or less the result of an ICMP echo request. Now, after the recent patches, you have probably noticed that your ping inside the scoreboard is lower than before and more in line with what you see for your connection to the data center. This is because the value in the scoreboard does no longer include the processing delays of the game. So this was basically a cosmetic change that doesn't have any impact on the actual gameplay. Then Ubisoft added icons which will make you aware of connectivity issues that might have a major impact on your experience. The latency icon will show up in yellow when your ping is higher than 120 milliseconds. When this happens, then you will notice more lag in the game, some of your shots might not register, and you will receive damage behind cover since it takes game data very long to travel between your client and the server. Should your ping exceed 490 milliseconds, which can happen when your router is suffering from buffer bloat, then almost none of your shots will register and you might get kicked from the server soon. If you want to find out more about what you can do against buffer bloat and the high ping that it causes, then you can find a link in the video description down below where I tell you more about that. Next is the connection icon, which is triggered by packet loss and high latency variation. The yellow icon shows up when you have more than 1% packet loss, which will result in occasional rubber banding, increased lag, and some of your shots might not register. Once you lose 9% of the packets, the icon will turn red. You then get severe rubber banding, much more lag, and your shots won't register anymore. If the packet loss stays this high, then you will also get disconnected from the server. Then we have the update rate icon, which looks a bit like the packet loss icon that you might know from Battlefield. This icon is triggered by a low frame rate, since the rate at which your client sends data to the server is affected by the render rate or frame rate of the client. More on that a little bit later. You will get the yellow icon when your frame rate is between 39 to 20 FPS. When this happens, then you will notice more lag and some of your shots might not register. Below 20 FPS, the icon will turn red. You then experience rubber banding, much more lag, and shots won't register anymore. So you better lower some of the graphic settings to make sure that your frame rate stays above 60 at all times. And while we're talking about frame rates, I really hope that the developers will eventually provide players with an option in the display settings menu which allows them to limit their frame rate at a specific value, like we can do in Overwatch. This would be really great as tools like RTSS can cause problems with the Uplay overlay, which then makes it impossible to invite friends to your squad or get invited by your friends. And last but not least, we've got an icon for the server performance, which will tell you that the server has some sort of a performance issue that you really can't do anything about. A yellow icon means that you might see some rubber banding, increased lag, and some of your shots might not register, while the red icon means that the server is in pretty bad shape and you can just hope that the match will end soon so that you can get on another server. Now, how about that 60 Hz tick rate? In my previous tests, I showed you that the game did not send and receive data at a fixed rate, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. Other games do this as well while providing low network delays. The reason why I mentioned this is to show how big the difference is between before and now after the 60 Hz patch, as Ubisoft now went for fixed update rates of 60 Hz for both the client and the server. The only time where you will see lower update rates is when the frame rate on the client goes below 60 FPS, as that directly affects how many updates per second the game client can send to the server, which also affects your online experience, so make sure that your frame rate stays above 60 at all times. Now, how does this thickened update rate change affect the delay that two players experience when they play on the same server? Back in September, I measured an average damage delay of 74.5 milliseconds, gunfire was delayed by 67 milliseconds on average, and player movement was delayed by 92.25 milliseconds on average. The recent optimizations, as well as the fixed thickened update rates of 60 Hz, had a quite massive impact on the delays, as the damage delay was brought down by 21 milliseconds, the gunfire delay by 25 milliseconds, and the movement delay by 32 milliseconds. When we then compare Rainbow Six Siege to other games, where you have to keep in mind that most of them were tested at a lower ping, then the game is finally closing the gap in terms of its network delay. Now, how about that infuriating issue where you die far behind cover, even though your ping to the server is very low? Before this patch, the server didn't really care about the ping of the shooter, which means that even at a ping of 400 milliseconds, you could quite easily hit other players who then received that shot far behind cover. That was not necessarily an advantage for the player with the high ping, but it was definitely an infuriating experience for the low ping player who received that shot very far behind cover. Now, after the patch, players who have a low ping to the server should have a much better experience when moving behind cover, as the server won't just register the shots of players who have a high ping. However, a player with a ping of 200 milliseconds can still land a lucky hit, as you can see here. Now, as nice as this is for those of us who can play the game at the low ping, it must also be said that there are many people out there who don't have servers near them and are forced to play at these high pings. So Ubisoft has to find a way to allow these players to play and enjoy the game, as they paid full price for it just like everyone else. One measure that might already help is if Ubisoft would take use of the Azure data centers located in India and eventually the new ones in South Africa, which Microsoft is building there. Now, what do these 60 Hz rates mean for the traffic that is generated by the game? Back in September, the game client sent 27.48 MB of data and received 35.01 MB of data. Now, at a stable 60 Hz, the download rate increased quite a bit. However, that shouldn't really cause an issue for the players, as the download bandwidth is usually much less of an issue, while developers have to be really careful with how much upstream bandwidth they use. And just to avoid any misunderstanding, the numbers that you see here are not a rating nor a ranking. I just want to show you how much traffic these games generate. So, the last two patches didn't only add useful network performance icons and significantly improve the network delay, they also enhanced the online experience for players who have a low ping. I've got to say that going into this, I did not expect such a positive outcome, as the last few patches didn't really change that much. The developers made really great progress here, and I hope that they keep improving the game by fixing the bugs that players have already started to report, by improving the network performance even further, by adding servers in more locations like India, and by adding an option that allows players to limit the frame rate at a specific value set by the player. Now, if you enjoyed this updated netcode analysis for Rainbow Six Siege, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, I simply could not continue to bring you these netcode analysis videos or input delay tests. So if you like my work, then you can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you can also do a one-time donation. If you want to stay up to date on what I'm currently working on, then you can follow me on Twitter or Facebook, the links are also in the description of this video. And if you don't want to miss the next one, then you might want to subscribe to my channel and click on that little bell icon below this video to receive a notification when I upload the next one. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.